My advanced miner's guide is finally done, so it's time to move on and look at some of the builds that I'm using when it comes to hunting cores and void opals. Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Elite Dangerous with Downgrowth Astronomy. So today I'm going to show you my preferred build when it comes to hunting cores, and I'm also going to try to make it more general so you can know where you can make changes to it to fit your playstyle a little bit better. So my preferred build is built on a Clipper. Fast, fairly maneuverable. I really like this ship because it really allows me to move quickly through the build, quickly locating the next rock. And the maneuverability of the ship also helps when it comes to moving around, setting up charges, moving in around the fragments to collect them later on. And also there's some nice layouts here. So this is my preferred build, but I'm going to run through it now. We're going to start with the hard points here. I'm going to start with the two medium slots here, of course. One abrasion blaster, one seismic charge launcher. And yes, I am aware that, at least at the time of this recording, there's a bug in the game where if you use multiple abrasion blasters, you can get multiple fragments, but again, it's a bug that has been recognized by Frontier that they say they are working on fixing. So to try and give this build a little bit more longevity, so it's also viable even after that bug has been corrected, then of course we'll only need one abrasion blaster. When it comes to the weaponry, you are pretty free to do what you want. I like the beam lasers because they do very well against shields, and they also can melt the hull and ships fairly quickly. For modifications here, I've gone with Efficient and Regeneration Sequence. Again, this is really optional. I would probably recommend Efficient if you're going with beam lasers, but the Regeneration Sequence was... I think I had them lying around already, and you can really do whatever you really like here. This is probably not the most optimal since wing mining is not really an option at the moment, so might want to change something here, but overall, in this version here, I have gone with Regeneration Sequence. When it comes to the utility mounts, there's no big surprises in here. Of course, we have a pulse wave scanner. I got with a 0A to get that 24-kilometer scan range, as much range as we can. And for the shield, then I have three shield boosters to give us as much shield as we can. It's not really necessary to have that much shield. It's nice to have some to be able to resist a rock blowing up, or if you get attacked by pirates, if you lock out in the belt, come back in, then pirates respawn. For the modifications here, I've gone with one with thermal spread and supercapacitor, another thermal resistant with supercapacitor, and finally a heavy duty with supercapacitor. Moving over to the core internals, I have done absolutely nothing to the lightweight alloy. You could, if you wanted to, put a heavy duty engineering modification on this. It will give you more hull, and there's really no drawbacks. It doesn't increase the mass because the mass of these is already zero, so it can't really be increased. So that could be an upgrade you could do if you want a little bit more hull, a little bit more, give you a little bit more time to get away if you get attacked. But again, this is really optional if you want to do that. For the power plant, 6A power plant, with it only grade 1 overcharged. We only need that grade 1 overcharge here to get enough power to make the whole thing run. So there's no reason to go all the way up to grade 5. It's just going to give you more heat and make this, the whole thing more heat. I can actually see here that I forgot to put the thermal spread on the power plant as a special modification. So I'll have to do that. But in ideally on the build, I would want thermal spread in here, but apparently I must have forgotten that during the build process. For the thrusters, of course, we want maneuverability, we want some speed, so dirty drive tuning with drag drives, it is. 5A frameshift drive, no surprises here either. Increased range and mass manager to get us that extra jump range. Derated the life support, of course, with a lightweight modification on it. Same thing with the sensors, also derated those and lightweighted it, so we don't really need the sensors that much, and lightweighting them just gave us more jump range. For the power distributor, 6A power distributor, again, not really necessary, but you can go, which modification there is, you can go with a smaller one. It's just, since I'm running beam lasers, it's nice to have that big power distributor. Charge enhanced and super conduit to get that recharge up. But again, you can go with a smaller one here if you are tight on the budget, and you can go with a different one here, but this is at least my recommendations. And, of course, for the more interesting parts here is the optional internals. For the class 7 and class 6 slots, I've gone with cargo. This gives us a total of 192 tons of cargo, which is takes, I don't know, about 2 hours-ish to fill up. Of course, it depends a lot on how good you are to locate the rocks and all that stuff. But at least around 200 tons of cargo, that is where I feel this is a good is a good size cargo, so I don't have to go back and forth that much. So that's what I've gone with. When it comes to the shield generator here, of course, I got with a 4A shield generator, fairly small for the ship size, reinforced in the high cap here. What you could also do here as an alternative is you could go with thermal spread high cap, with a thermal resistant high cap, and if you do that, then you would have to go into your utility mount, and you would have to get rid of these two thermal resistant shield boosters, and then probably get one or two resistance augmented, and then one heavy duty, or two heavy duty and one resistance augmented. That's up to you whether you want hit points or more resistant. Okay, so that's optional. You can do the engineering there differently if you want to. You can also upgrade to a prismatic shield. Also a very solid option here. If you do that, you'll probably need more power, but as we saw with the power plant, we do have the overhead to just put a few more levels of overcharge on the power plant, so we get that extra power, which should give us enough to actually run a prismatic shield generator if we want to. And of course, if you're really staffed for power, you can also downgrade those beam lasers, which are also fairly power-hungry weapons. So there are definitely some options here to upgrade the shields if you want to, if you have access to the prismatic shield generators. I didn't have an available 4A of class 4 shield, prismatic shield, which is why I just went A-rated, and to be honest, it's worked just fine for me. It would give a little bit more survivability in the ship if you go with prismatics. But again, it is really an option here, and it's really optional what you want to go with here. Okay, for collectors, I've gone with 2 3A collector limpet controllers, giving me a total of 4 active limpets. I like it, the 4 active. It is a little overkill. What you can do is you can go down to just 1 if you suggest have 1 active, so you can have 2 active instead of 4 as I have now. And then maybe you could put in a little bit extra cargo or something else, like a fuel scoop if you're planning to go longer ranges. Guardian FSD booster could also go to add, like, I think it's 8 extra light years you could get out of the class 4 slot here if you wanted to. Pushing your light year, your jump range up to like close to the 40 light years. Which is pretty good, I think. So that is some options here if you don't... I like to have the extra limpets. I normally don't have to go that far from the belt. That is an issue. So that's why I've gone with 2 collector limpets controllers here. And I should say, you could also, if you really want to optimize the build, which I haven't done here, is you can go and put lightweight modification to these. They are 8 tons each. And you could remove 80% of the mass by going lightweight. So there's an option here for what you could do to optimize that a little bit. Same story with the prospector here. You don't really need 2 active prospectors, but it's a nice quality of life upgrade to the ship. But same thing here. Since we're really using our lower slots anyway for others, I'll talk about it when it comes to refinery here. What you could swap that out for a 1A with only 1 active to get a bigger refinery. But that's really again an option. And again, here you could lightweight this. This is 5 tons. These are even lighter. But if you want, like, really, if you're going for something that go deep space, you have to travel really far, then you might want to lightweight these to get that mass off. And then we come to the refinery. I've gone with only a 2A refinery, which has 6 active bin counts. Now, often when we do core hunting, the number of different materials that's going to be available in the cores are very limited. I think it's rare you're going to see more than like 4 maybe different materials in a given belt. So having 6 bins is really more than you really need. It should be enough. But if you really want more, a higher bin count, what you could do was you could go in and upgrade to a 3A refinery to get more bin counts, and then you could downgrade your prospector limit controller to a 1A, and then only have 1 active prospector, which really should be enough. So again, there are some options here for what you could do. I like these because it's a nice quality of life thing, but again, there are some changes that you can do here. And of course, last one in our class 2 slot here, detailed surface scanner. I really recommend that you fit this on your mining ship. It makes it a lot easier that you can just go scan the belt, drop in. You don't have to scan it in one ship, come back, change ship, and go out, find it again. And that's just going to take you a lot longer. So that's why I really recommend that you fit a detailed surface scanner on the ship here. So that is the build as it is, as it stands right now, the way I use it. As you can see, there are definitely some options to where you can do some changes to the ship to fit your playstyle a little bit better. I mean, if you really wanted to use this to go into deep space, you can get that for a fuel scoop on, and you can also potentially push the jump range a little bit by lightweighting some of these modules. I mean, you're going to save 8 tons by changing out that collector. And if you are a little bit more conservative with mass of some of your other, maybe the weapon slots and your core internals, then you could probably push this, as I said, up to close to a 40 light year jump, which is pretty good for a mining ship, making this a potential decent deep space miner if you really want to go far. I mean, I very recently launched my video on how to find the perfect mining spot, which is the last video in the Advanced Miner's Guide series. And in that, I also mentioned the fact that you might want to travel a little bit further from the station where you're sailing in order to get better spots, to get better yield out of your asteroids. And that could be a way to try and work with that if you're planning to go even further away from the station, that you might want to go with a little bit extra range. But again, there are some options here where you can change things around. This is what I've gone with. It works very well for me. I'm very happy with the build. And even though I don't have the thermal spread on it, I don't have issues with heat. So again, really, really happy with this build. And you can see you can get pretty far with fairly minimal engineering. I mean, even the shields upgrades here are optional. There's nothing really here that you have to do, but a lot of it just makes your life a lot easier. I think only the the power plant upgrade is probably mandatory to get the ship flying, but other than that, you're pretty much free to make some changes. I'll make sure to drop a link in the description below, so you can go and you can get the link and you can then begin to make your own alterations to it. I'll probably try to do the fully engineered version in the build link, so not the one that you're seeing here where I have added some of the last, so you just can see how it would look in the final and absolute fully engineered form. But anyway, let's stop rambling for now. I hope you like this video. Let me know also in the comments, what would you change? And feel free also to share your builds down there. So if you make alterations to this build, or if you have a completely different build. So if people are maybe not that that fond of this build, go in the description or in the comment section and see what people have posted down there. Links will of course be helpful review, but I'll make sure to approve them when as they come. But anyway, thanks a lot for watching, guys. I hope you liked this video. If you did, give it a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And until next time, I will see you guys in space.